Online. Hello, everybody. This is Swarmlord39 of Almost Cool, back with another episode of Subnautica. Now, if you remember last time, we hopped down into the edge of the Lost River biome to attempt to collect a bunch of resources to begin building up several different various, you know, buildings and upgrades, such as unlocking the, birds. But yeah, they're probably not going to be over here. Unlocking the, jump jet upgrade for our prawn suit. Upgrade, yeah, it was the jet jump upgrade specifically, and possibly also the prawn suit, the prawn suit depth module, allowing us to go even deeper. Be essential for it, and eventually we would want to get up to this, but that requires kyanite, which we can't currently get to. And then we already have the armor mod installed, so this thing would be pretty well kitted out. Now, among other things, we needed to get back down to Lost River again, to allow ourselves further access into it, but at the same time, I don't have the range. Need range. Copper and magnetite, really? That's it? Silver and gold for the other one. Let's do two each. We don't have enough silver for that, so we'll just shove the silver ones back in, but we can get the range increase. Fine. Yeah, let's go and make a couple range increases for that and see if we can allow us to find some stalker teeth. Stalker teeth are actually the biggest detriment we have to getting our Cyclops. Would allow us a mobile base. Really? That's supposed to be us. Creature egg. Link creature egg nearby. I'm guessing either we still don't have the range or something. It might be that have to build one elsewhere near closer to one of the kelp forests, which would be annoying, but possible. Anyway, so again, we were planning on eventually going back to Lost River. I'm actually thinking, because I'm fairly tired today, and I'm not sure I'd be able to handle it. I have a thing of metal salvage in here that I haven't turned into freaking titanium. More of it! Where did I put the freaking? There it is. Yeah, you see, this is the problem I'm having to deal with, and I don't think it is a good idea for me to go into potentially hydrochloric acid and polyaniline. There we frickin' go. I think I'm going to attempt to make the Cyclops today. Why? Well, why not? Question isn't why, it's why not. Where are the other two? Where? Creature decoy. Okay. Oh, the planting pot. Oh, right. We haven't gotten Alien Containment. We'll probably get that once we actually get over there with the Cyclops. Oh, yeah. I also would like to try to get another moon pool attached to the base so that we can actually dock our... Seamoth. Although, if we get the Cyclops, it's not going to be that as big a deal. Anywho. Oh, this is going to hurt. Ow. Or not. Oops. I didn't check my inventory. That was a stupid idea. Anywho, I need lubricant, which I believe requires a creepvine seed cluster. I'm wrong with her. Anything else? Welcome aboard, Captain. Nope, we have a lubricant. Okay, 1, 2, 3, right. Print. Yes. Now we need some glass. Where is this? Quartz. Let's make that titanium ink, that other titanium ingot. Because we need several titanium, we need several plasteel ingots. Which, advanced material, no, basic materials require 2 lithium thing. But more than that, we need 5, 6. Okay. More than that, we need all the ingots. We have 1, 2, 5, 6, 9, 10. Have enough titanium. This will put any sort of plan on hold until we get more titanium after this. But so, our goal is to go looking for Stalker Teeth. Because that's... I'll get the lithium real quick. It was in this one. Yes. There we go. Lots of materials for this, but it's the Cyclops. It's one of the most resource-intensive things in the entire game. Of course, it would be. Right, here's a quest. No, never mind. We'll back later. So yeah, all we need is the enameled glass, which very specifically requires Stalker Teeth, which is very specifically something we do not have. Going.
Welcome aboard, Captain.
I hate finding the lights on. Especially because I don't know if it actually drains power or not. It doesn't. It seems like it doesn't. But I also recall seeing something that wasn't fully charged when I got up to it later, after I know it had been fully charged. I am looking for Stalker Teeth, and this is a really annoying part. Stalker Teeth are so hard to find. Oh, here's some Stalkers. I mean, I seem to recall also that in the past, it was possible for Stalker Teeth to come from them attacking the sea moth. But I don't think that's a thing anymore. Which, that kind of disappoints me. If they lose it from picking up titanium scrap, don't mind me, I'm just picking up the scrap because, well, we just ran through our entire supply of titanium. If it's gonna be sitting there really easy to pick out, of course I'm going to take it. I'm just not going looking for it specifically. I need to make sure I have enough room for three frickin', I forgot to drop off everything. Okay. I was holding the wrong, I had my fingers in the wrong position. Dang it, you're tempting me right there. There's a piece of pieces of titanium scrap, which might Docker teeth. Where'd they go? That's a stalker tooth. Okay, now we just need to make sure. Okay, got one stalker tooth. Perfect. One third of the way there. That was just, and in an odd position. Another one. Oh my gosh, this was a lot easier than I thought it was gonna be. Hi there. Be alone. I'm just trying to pick up the teeth that you're losing. Ignore me. Probably gonna see me. There's a lot of them right here. Both good and bad. Good because that means we have a lot of chances for stalkers to drop. For stalker teeth to drop. Bad because, well, if they do, there's one. There is no freaking way we're going. Right here. What was that? What was that? We got what we needed. Okay, we're heading home. I have no idea what that sound was, and quite frankly, that scarified the bejeebus out of me just hearing that sound. Oh my gosh. If it's just an egg hatching sound, I've never heard it before. So, pardon me if you're laughing at me for being a wimp for that. If there's something else, if it's something, but I honestly don't know what it is. So, therefore, I have no reason to find out what it is. Therefore, I'm heading back home. Especially because, again, it's one of those things where we had what we needed. I had no reason to stick around. Yeah, now we can get the enameled glass, which is the last thing we need to get this to get our frickin' Cyclops. The enameled glass, and I'm going to immediately turn those back into titanium because that way I know actually know how much titanium I have. Unlike the last several times where I was looking and thinking, holy crap, I'm out of titanium this entire time, when I wasn't. like an idiot, and probably several of you who watch, and it probably you people who watch were like, you idiot, you have scrap. I feel really bad, especially because I've done that to other people. I've done that to a few other ones that I've watched.
Cannot build here. Must be constructed in deep the water.
Whoa, that's new. Glad to see though that they have a thing. Pack up in the mobile vehicle bay. You've got to put that somewhere deeper. Go this way. I mean, I don't want to potentially have it drop on our base. If I release it, will it face away? It face away. It's deep enough.
Cannot build here.
Dang it.
Must be constructed in deeper water.
So the hard part wasn't the Socrates. The hard part is putting the vehicle builder in a place where I'm gonna have enough space for it to drop.
Cannot build here.
Really?
Be constructed in deeper water.
No, I wanted to pack it up. I missed. Okay, seriously? Okay. This is about as far out as I'm willing to go. If this doesn't work, I'm gonna flip. There we go!
New blueprint acquired. Be advised, the Cyclops is designed to be operated by a 3-person crew. Only experienced Helms people should attempt to pilot this vehicle solo.
I'm guessing just a few of those outcroppings were what was throwing it off, not the overall thing.
Welcome aboard, Captain. All systems online.
Alright, turn on the engine.
Powering up.
Accidentally hit those. And in one of those things where I'd like to have it at least nearby, I'm probably going to, as usual, dock.
Engine powering dock.
What name it? We have the Discovery, we have the Titan. I don't know. And if you notice, I'm not really very big on the different colorations, and that's someone on purpose because also I know I'm not incredibly artistically inclined. Oh, that's what's going on. Okay. Oh, yeah, we have one of those. Don't have that or that. Wow. Yeah, so we'll move the Titan into here. Because the Titan is the one that we actually will be taking with us when we go around with the Cyclops.
Welcome aboard, Captain.
Welcome
There we go. Alrighty, and now we've got the Titan loaded up. Oh, right, I can actually access the inventory and mods here. Great. And now we can put the Discovery back into the moon pool. So while I'd love to get a second moon pool, it's now a little bit redundant. As long as, you know, we don't lose our,
Welcome aboard, microbes. Captain.
There we go. Discovery docked. Okay, also, let's see. Let's try to get the prawn suit jet jump upgrade real quick. That was 2 nickel, 3 sulfur, 5 titanium, and a lithium. Got lithium, got 3 sulfur, and then we had the 5 titanium. I put it down somewhere. Where did I put it down? Make this, and I'm gonna go grab and eat, and I'm also gonna grab the Cyclops engine efficiency module. Eating that, so grab food, grab the efficiency module, head back over to our fortress, easy name. Go. All full up. Now, I know I've got a Cyclops efficiency here somewhere. Oh, yeah. Isn't it salt plus those mix advanced materials? Yeah, salt and 3 deep shrooms make hydrochloric acid needed, plus a gold for polyaniline. Yeah, okay, so we actually have a use for salt now. Another use for salt now. One that isn't reliant on us making even more of something that we don't need. On aboard. Access modules and flip in the jump jet upgrade. So now we just need the pressure module, and we'll eventually get the heat power one. Although I might choose to get the energy efficiency until we get to that point. Additionally, other side, we'll put in Cyclops module efficiency. So now our engines are more efficient and use less power. Which is good, because it is a pain in the butt to keep this, to power this thing back up. Anywho, wow, that's been most of the episode. I don't know. You know what? Let's go see if those deep shrimps have grown. And try to maybe grab a few, and if they have, grab a few, and try to see if I can make that efficiency module. Yeah, they grew. And not scandalous? to speak anyway. As you can tell, that's not a hard fast rule. Right, and now we need some salt. We also need to grab a gold. Too much salt. Hydrochloric acid. Polyaniline. Oh, nice. Okay, now... can't make any... I mean, it's nothing new in electronics. Nothing new in foibles. Right. Equipment. Equipment that we hadn't been able to... I think, yeah. None of those. It was all over in mods and... Oh yeah, charge fan. That's something we should be able to do. Those we'll need to get more nickel to get a depth mod. This is gonna be one of those cases where I'm probably just gonna move things over into probably gonna move the modification station as well as a anvil fabricator over there. That way I can actually, while this will still be our main base of operations, our fortress, well, that will be. Our new, that will be a, right, we need a computer chip. Also, I want to get another hull reinforcement. Oh, really? Thermal suit reactor requires multi-polyaniline. And I already forgot what I was running over here for. We did that. Probably want a sonar. But I... energy efficiency module requires a computer chip. I don't think we have a spare computer chip at the moment. I could be totally wrong. No spare computer. Okay. Just reminding myself what I need for a computer chip. Copper wire, gold, and table core. Okay. Right. I just used all our copper. Okay. And looking through this will not bring it back. Yay! Ah! Why do I have the artifacts on me? I don't need them on me. I'm guessing I was thinking that I'd go all the way through, but I wasn't really thinking straight. I guess we could go out with our Cyclops and our Titan and go mining out near the out that way again, near the Blood Kelp Zone. Zone and get more copper. But we're basically out of time and with nothing really else that I can think of doing. Because I am tired, so sue me. Right, what do I need for a fabricator? I might, depending on what I need for the fabricator. Where is it? Come on. And it's probably way down because of course it would be. Yeah, there we go. Fabricator. Oh, that's easy. That one's a little harder, but I already said we'd basically get over anyway. Ding. So I need a gold, a table coral, and a titanium. Okay. Easy peasy. Bloop. Bloop. Titanium. Gold. One of these days I'll also get a system that I can actually sort with. And table coral. Bam. Let's go build Let's go rebuild the modification station over here, and also build the fabricator that we're gonna have on here.
Welcome aboard, Captain. All systems online.
Now the question is, where do we want to build it? Interior modules, fabricator. We could just build it right here in the corner, but I'd rather build it. I like building it in here. Modification station right here. Other two I'd want to put in here are this, that will move it over, and that, which we do have enough resources for. Question is, do we want to actually waste that copper? No, let's not waste the copper. Let's just kill one. I mean, it's not like we really need it. I mean, if we really wanted to use one, we're not that far from the actual life pod. So, we're gonna pull the radio and the, this. No. No, we're not using that computer chip. We're going to rebuild that thing, mostly because I still want to be able to get medical kits. And while it's not saying that I don't want to eventually rebuild one on back in the habitat, because having everything on this thing which can be destroyed versus the habitat which can't be destroyed is really stupid, in my opinion. Don't judge, please. That's not to say that you know, I necessarily need it over there. There we go. Got the basics all set up right there. Perfect. Okay, and I think that might be a very good place to leave it off. Well, guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. We actually managed to get a Cyclops. And it is glorious, and we now just need to start getting resources to finish kitting out the Titan and our Cyclops, and then we can start pushing down deeper. And since we've got the we'll probably end up making a couple lockers and fill them with the various organic parts we need from our garden, our deep shrooms, our blood oils, our creep vines, our acid mushrooms, bell sacks, and all that, just because I really did an eclipse. I think it was just an eclipse. Because I really don't want to go down there and find out that the one critical piece I'm missing is something that's just growing in the garden up here. But yeah, until next time, this is Swarmlord39 signing out. See ya.